now I will demonstrate the complete intubation procedure for you. First, we need to lubricate the ET tube and the insertion part with the lubricant. And then connect the ET tube to the insertion part. Here we need an sterilization adapter. It is used to connect the endoscope with the ET tube to prevent the ET tube sliding down to affect intubation procedure. And we turn on the device. If the image is normal, you need to perform the Y variance to get a better image covered. And we also need another accessory named the guide braid put in the mouth of the patient to prevent the patient biting the insertion tube. Here, hold the distal end between the first and the second index. Should straighten the insertion tube, bend it up slightly to 30 degrees. Inserts into patient's mouth. When you cannot see the direction, you can withdraw the insertion tube to find more space and see clearer. Always remember to keep the insertion tube straight and in the middle of the patient's mouth. This is very important to the successful intubation. Do not bend the insertion tube like this and keep your eyes on the monitor. Make sure the image is in the middle of the screen. And also, if necessary, you can rotate to the left or right. And now, you can see the inward. When you see the epiglottis, slightly turn, press the control knob down and pass through the vocal cord, tracheal rings. As you pass the vocal cord 3 to 5 centimeters, you see the cleaner, you can disconnect the ET tube and insert. And withdraw the endoscope slightly. And then connect the ET tube to the ventilator. And take off the guide braid and also turn off the device.